Are you operating a boiler? Suddenly the pressure drops and the entire factory comes to a halt. What would you do? Just remember this one principle, and you'll be able to troubleshoot the issue in no time. Main content. Hello everyone. It's a pleasure to see you again in today's video about from DIVI. As part of our troubleshooting series for industrial boilers, today's topic is sudden pressure drop in a boiler, causes and solutions. I'm certain that if you're in any way involved with boilers, you'll find this topic highly relevant. This type of issue, while not necessarily dangerous to the operator, can lead to significant production losses if not handled promptly and correctly. So without further delay, let's dive right in. Please note that the scope of this video focuses only on standard industrial steam boilers. Now imagine this, your boiler is operating normally and suddenly a low pressure alarm light starts flashing, or the low pressure buzzer goes off, or the operator sees the steam pressure gauge drop below the required operating level. How would you feel in that moment? Personally, I've been in that exact situation more than once during my early days installing boilers. When pressure drops too low, the plant must halt operations. Every department affected by the stoppage will start calling the boiler team. The pressure, no pun intended, is on you if you're in charge of the boiler. So what should we do in this case? Here's the one core principle you must remember. If all other safety systems, such as low water alarms, phase loss protection, etc., are operating normally, and only the low pressure alarm is triggered, then the most common cause of this issue lies in the fuel combustion process. This combustion process is governed by two factors, oxygen and fuel. If there's only oxygen but no fuel, combustion won't occur. If there's only fuel but no oxygen, combustion still won't occur. And even if both are present but poorly mixed, combustion will be inefficient, all of which can lead to a drop in pressure. Therefore, the first thing you must do when this issue occurs is to check both the fuel and oxygen systems. Step 1. Check inside the combustion chamber. When checking the combustion chamber, you may find one of the following three scenarios. Case 1. The fuel level is low or completely absent. In that case, immediately check the fuel feeding system. Common causes include 1. The fuel is too large in size or too wet, causing it to get stuck and not feed through the hopper into the combustion chamber. 2. The conveyor or screw feeder isn't operating, possibly due to a broken belt, broken sprocket, chain, or a burnt out motor. 3. When fuel gets stuck, many operators, under pressure to restore pressure quickly, tend to drastically increase the fuel feed rate. But this can overload the combustion chamber with unburned fuel, smother the flame, or cause poor combustion, making the pressure drop even further. Operators must understand, fuel should only be increased gradually to ensure proper combustion. Rushing this process can worsen the pressure drop. Case 2. Fuel level appears normal, but pressure is still low. Then you should immediately check the primary air fan, forced draft, and the induced draft fan, exhaust fan. If the primary air fan is not working, there won't be enough oxygen in the combustion chamber, which reduces combustion efficiency and steam generation. If the induced draft fan is not working, smoke cannot flow through the heat exchangers. This also reduces steam generation and causes smoke to back up and fill the boiler room. The result? Steam production decreases and boiler pressure drops. Case 3. Both fans are working properly. Then you must check fuel quality. In some cases, the calorific value of the fuel may be too low due to excessive moisture content, mold or decay, high levels of impurities like sand, gravel, or rocks. If such impurities clog the air holes on the grate, they reduce oxygen supply and lower combustion efficiency. In this case, you'll need to rake out the debris to restore airflow through the grate. Additionally, if the fuel quality is too poor, such as overly moist biomass, moldy wood, or low calorific agricultural waste, you should supplement the combustion process with high calorific fuels like wood pellets or dry chopped wood. This helps compensate for the lack of thermal energy and allows the boiler pressure to recover faster. At DIVI, we've implemented this solution in several projects. For example, when using wet or inconsistent fuel, we always keep backup high energy fuel on site. In emergencies, operators can mix in this supplemental fuel to stabilize the fire and quickly restore steam pressure. If the fuel has poor calorific value, you should supplement with high energy fuel like wood pellets or dry chopped wood. Otherwise, increasing the feed rate of low calorific fuel without adjusting the air ratio will make the problem worse. Step 3. Adjust excessive fuel feeding if present. If you observe an abnormally high amount of fuel in the chamber, check the feeder frequency. A system error might be feeding too much fuel without adjusting the air ratio, which hampers combustion. In this case, reduce or temporarily stop the fuel feed and use a rake to fluff and spread the fuel. This increases surface area for oxygen contact, improving combustion and steam recovery. Once combustion is stable, reset the feeder speed to its normal setting. Visual inspection for combustion. To check combustion status, use the observation port on the combustion chamber. If no observation port is available, carefully open the firebox door. Always stand behind the door to avoid potential backdrafts or flashbacks. Alternatively, reduce or shut off the primary air fan before opening the door for inspection or fuel raking to prevent flames from flaring outward. Check boiler water supply system. If the combustion system seems normal, the issue might lie in the boiler water supply. You might be supplying too much feed water compared to steam usage, or you might be feeding water that's too cold into the boiler. Let's explore these further. Case 1, excessive feed water volume. Possible cause, a faulty or inaccurate water level sensor. Too much water can lower pressure by overwhelming the system, carrying water into the steam lines, and triggering the feed pump to inject even more cold water. Meanwhile, combustion and oxygen supply remain the same, so steam generation drops. To verify this, check the water level gauges, sight glasses. If both show equal levels within the safe range, this isn't the issue. If no level is visible, the drum is likely overfilled. To confirm, blow down the sight glasses. If readings are inaccurate, inspect and replace the level sensors immediately. Case 2, feed water too cold. Normally, the system uses a deaerator tank to preheat the feed water to 102, 105 degrees C before it enters the economizer. If the deaerator isn't properly heated, cold water enters the boiler. Even with the economizer, this water may not be heated enough. When cold water hits hot steam generating zones, it reduces the overall temperature quickly, dropping steam pressure. In this case, check the deaerator tank temperature and make sure its steam heating system is functioning properly. Summary of key solutions. These are some common causes of sudden boiler pressure drop based on DIVI's real-world experience. If you have other causes or solutions to add, please share them in the comments. So how can we prevent this issue from happening in the first place? Based on DIVI's experience, here are 9 essential practices. First, avoid operator inattention, especially during night shifts. It's a common human error. At the CAMSO project, for example, DIVI installed 2 oil-fired boilers for rental. The operation was simple, but the repetitive work made it easy for operators to fall asleep. After repeated warnings from security, they learned to stay alert by walking around the boiler and checking equipment regularly. Second, make sure your fuel quality is consistent. If the fuel pieces are too big or too wet, they can clog the hopper or stick together, blocking the feed system. Check the fuel's moisture level regularly. Wet fuel not only burns poorly, but can also lead to pressure loss and higher fuel costs. Third, install proper alarm systems. You need clear low-pressure alarms, well-marked pressure gauges showing safe limits, and good lighting to make them easy to read. Fourth, never let new operators work alone. Always have experienced staff supervise them until they fully understand how to adjust fuel, air, and pressure settings safely. Fifth, perform regular maintenance on key components like the screw feeder, conveyors, air fans, and exhaust fans. Especially after year 3, you should check motor bearings, change gearbox oil, repaint insulation, and lubricate moving parts on schedule. Next, make sure to grease all moving components like sprockets, chains, and shafts. Without proper lubrication, dust and moisture can cause corrosion and wear, eventually leading to breakdowns. Another important point, pay attention to the coupler pin, or cavette, as it's often called in southern Vietnam, that connects the motor to pulleys or gears. Some operators use construction rebar, like Phi-6 or Phi-10 as a shortcut, but these break easily. Always use the right hardened material. Also, don't forget to regularly check boiler water levels using the sight glass. If the readings are unclear or inaccurate, blow down the sight glass and inspect the sensors. DIVI has a full video tutorial on how to do this. Check the link in the description. And finally, always monitor the temperature of the deaerator or feed water tank. If it drops below normal, take immediate action to restore steam heating before it affects boiler performance. You may be wondering, what about fouling or scale buildup inside the boiler? Could that cause pressure drop? Yes, but these develop gradually, not suddenly. For that issue, please refer to our video titled Three Signs Your Boiler is Losing Efficiency. Link is in the description below. These are practical, field-tested solutions from DIVI to help you quickly resolve pressure drop issues in industrial boilers. If you found this helpful, please like, share, and comment to support us in sharing more valuable technical knowledge. We look forward to seeing you in the next video from DIVI.